final concert of the season. My name's Adam. I'm one of the baritone singers in the bass section of the choir. Before we start singing, I just wanted to go over a couple of housekeeping, general housekeeping. So for tonight's concert, our singers will remain masked, and we ask you to do the same. Our conductor will remove their masks, our conductors will remove their masks on the podium, so that they may more effectively communicate with the members of the chorus. The windows will remain open during the concert, which will help with ventilation, but also loud noises could end up finding their way into the performance space. Do not be alarmed. We will do our best to draw focus away from those loud noises. On the topic of non-choral noises, cell phones can also be quite a distraction. So as a previous choral conductor of mine used to say, remember to set those phones to stun during the concert. Once again, thank you for spending your evening with us, and please join me in welcoming the Northwest Chamber Chorus.
Thank you. Yes. How can we keep from singing? We can't. We sang through the lockdown. Thank goodness for nearly this whole season, we've been right here in this room every Monday singing together because we can't keep from doing it. When we sing together, we have the ability to express the full range of human emotions. So we can begin our program with that joyous outburst from Sarah Quartel from Toronto, and we can follow it immediately with this elegy by Arthur Sullivan, yes, of Gilbert and Sullivan. For two decades they were banging out those comic operettas that some of us listened to because our mom played them in the living room all the time. But before that, way before that, here is Arthur Sullivan as a young man writing this piece to a friend of his that he had lost. We'll follow that with Sing Me to Heaven by Daniel Gothrop. He was commissioned to write a song that describes the way that we as singers feel about the music in our lives. He liked that. He liked that idea. And he tried and tried and tried to find the right text that he could set to do exactly that, and he never found it. And she would later write, he whined to his wife about it. And she happened to be a poet. So this piece, Sing Me to Heaven, turned out to be their first professional collaboration. You're a part of this performance. And we have something special to ask of you tonight. Something more and something less that we'd like for you to do with us. Sometimes at the end of a piece, it's nice to be still and let the music hang in the air. There will be a few moments like that in this program where we'll ask you to ponder quietly between pieces. And so here's the first time like that. Please hold your applause until after we finish Sing Me to Heaven. Kevin Siegfried was a Seattleite when he arranged the Shaker song Lay Me Low. In this arrangement, you can find elements that echo Shaker furniture design: simplicity, honesty, balance. You'll hear a simple text in four parts with a single verse repeated four times. Each time the verse is repeated, another voice part is added, and then another, and then another. So it creates a simple emotional crescendo that's punctuated by a tender refrain between the verses. And once more, we ask you to let the silence linger until we finish the next selection from the early Baroque sacred choral music of Heinrich Schütz, Selig sind die Toten. I've been told since junior high to not wave at people in the audience. I hope you didn't see me do that. All right, let's serious up here, Klepper. Spanish-born Venezuelan composer and choral director and educator and social activist Alberto Grau is a leading figure in the international choral community. Casar Mielagahi, written over 30 years ago, takes as its cause the international mobilization to save the earth. The sub-Saharan slogan Casar Mielagahi means the earth is tired. Grau creates sounds of creation, destruction, anger, weariness, and he instructs the choir in places to, quote, imitate the sound of the wind blowing through a desolate landscape. You may feel free to express yourself at the end of Casar Mielagahi.
Casar Mielagahi.
Thank you, you did well. We'll wrap this first half of our concert with two songs containing the idea of going home to heaven with very different styles and affects. First, Susan Brumfield combines two camp songs into one cohesive arrangement of No Time. And then William Dawson, the great William Dawson, the great chronicler of African-American spirituals, has set Soon I Will Be Done This Time. You're welcome to applaud between the songs. And then there will be an intermission.
Hi, everyone. I'm really happy to be here with you. And my name is Eggie, and I joined this choir last September as I'm in cultural exchange program, and I'm here in America for a year, or maybe two. And I'm really happy to be here in the front of the choir. And I introduced choir with one of our famous, most famous composers from Latvia, Erik Sešenvalds, and his music. And we're gonna sing you Erik Sešenvalds, my song. And I first heard the song when I was 15 years old. I was in Riga, that is the capital of Latvia, and there were world choir games, and there were so many people from all around the world, and Erik Sešenvalds wrote the song for this special festival. And I remember I was not in the big choir with all of the singers, but because I was a little bit too young, but I remember the feeling of the big choir singing all of this together, and you will listen to the lyrics and you will probably understand what I'm talking about. So enjoy.
This song of mine will find its music around you like the fond arms of love. This song of mine will carry your sight into the heart of things like a faithful star in the dark night over your
I
We have a very, very special thanks tonight to give to our last minute fill-in accompanist. Allie Webb is our normal collaborative pianist. And I got a text from Allie yesterday morning that said she tested positive for COVID. She teaches elementary school, and you know, an elementary school music teacher sees all of those kids every day. Not every day. Anyway, Allie was unable to be with us. And Dori Bounsgaard sat in at the almost the last, very last minute. Dori, thank you so much. You're just wonderful. I can't imagine how fortunate we all are. If you're following along in your program, which you ought to be, I hope you are, you know that this next piece has been dedicated to Marilyn Newland, and I want to tell you a little bit about Marilyn. She has been a generous financial supporter, but she's also a modest person, so she never sought any recognition for her contributions. But her support, she supported us in other ways as well. Her children sang with us. AJ, her daughter, is with us. Hi, AJ. She's back there waving. Hi, AJ. AJ was here last week when we had this concert as well. Marilyn, sometimes when we go on tour, it's not uncommon for someone to bring along a spouse or a significant other or family members, but Marilyn brought her children and her grandchildren on the tour bus in 2001 as this chorus toured through France and Italy. She's been a regular in our audience and at our auctions for many, many, many years. She was also an organist at several churches in the Seattle area, and she and her daughter, AJ, were both members of Plymouth Congregational Church downtown. It's a wonderful concert venue, a place where we performed for many years as well, and it was through Marilyn that we made the connection so that we could use that other wonderful concert venue. It is fitting that AJ chose Ubi Caritas to dedicate to her mom. The text says, where charity and love are, God is there. And my favorite line in the program, with a sincere heart, let us love one another. This is Ubi Caritas by Ola Yelo. Yes, well, shame on me. Now I've got you guessing. I'll try to be more clear. Eshti Dal is a song that I first heard about when we were planning to tour Eastern Europe. I know some of the members of the audience were on that bus as well. And a friend of mine said, well, if you're going to Hungary, you've got to sing Eshti Dal. And I said, what? I didn't know this song. Oh, my goodness. Zoltán Kodály, perhaps the most famous of all Hungarian composers and educators. In this song, we hear from a soldier at night, alone, cold, frightened, asking for help, for help. Once more, let this one linger without applause. We sing this song in solidarity with the people of Ukraine. Our March program featured some of the art songs of Harry T. Burley. He also created choral arrangements of lots of African-American spirituals. Here is his little American masterpiece, his modest and beautiful arrangement of My Lord, What a Morning.
Thank you.
Renee Claussen, the long, long time conductor and composer from Concordia College in Minnesota, adapted his text of Set Me as a Seal from the Song of Solomon. It speaks to the power of music to express and heal even deep grief. As he and his wife endured the deepest sorrow a parent can face, he set this text so beautifully. The song emerges so much more about love than about death. And please, no applause until the end of the next song, I Should Be Glad. Susan Labar wrote about this song. I Should Be Glad is a work that attempts to capture the gratitude that many of us feel, I'm sure many of you feel, as we live and work as artists. The poem expresses a sentiment that our hard work is worth the long hours if it means that we are able to put art into the world and make a difference in the lives of others. Quick, before I wave at someone else. We want to thank the church. Finney Ridge Lutheran Church has been our home for years and years, and they were so flexible with us during the lockdown, and we're just very, very grateful to them, their staff, and all the members of the church as well. I'm sure I hope there's some of you here. We also, if you purchased a ticket or you had someone check your, I don't know if we're still checking vaccinations at the door. Yes, okay, great. If someone handed you a program, those are all volunteers, and we could not get by without our volunteers. Many of them are here in the audience now. Thank you. Thanks to them. And if you want to come and be a volunteer, just talk to one of those volunteers, and we'll hook you up for our next concert. We will see you next in this room in December, although we'll be here between now and then. But in fact, we're back here on Monday to get ready for the next season. I hear you, Jane. I'm talking too much. Arise, Beloved, is our final song by Rosephony Powell. We've sung many songs by Rosephony Powell. We love to take her with us on tour. Not her, but her music. She is a very sought-after clinician, and she likes to conduct these big mass choirs, these all-state choirs and other big mass combined gatherings of choirs. And she works out of Auburn University in Alabama, so she's really, really popular in that part of the country and here in Seattle. She also has adapted her text from the Song of Solomon, and here she uses nature as a backdrop and a means to express love and passion. Even in these uncertain times, we hope that each of us can draw our own inspiration and manifest beauty as we go out from here. And we wish you all a summer of beauty and goodness. From Rosephony Powell, Arise, Beloved.